Well, it's early in the tropical season, but we already have the first hurricane. It is Hurricane Aletta in the eastern Pacific Ocean. Let's take a look at the latest coordinates for you folks tracking this early season system. By the way, right on schedule, since the tropical season begins on May 15th officially in the eastern Pacific. So right on schedule, Hurricane Aletta, 15.1 north, 107.7 west, 530 miles west-southwest of Acapulco. Top winds up there above 100 miles per hour at this point. The hurricane, though, drifting west. Good news there. That takes it out into the open waters of the Pacific. The pressure 974 millibars. Satellite picture, impressive, a symmetrical cloud pattern. With it, no eye visible, but there probably is one there underneath a high, thin veil of cloudiness over the actual eye. And the outflow, upper-level winds aloft remain favorable for it to maintain its strength. And then in the long-range forecast, say 48 hours down the road, Aletta should begin to weaken. But first hurricane of the season here in the eastern Pacific, moving away from the coast of Mexico. Back into the lower 48 here in the United States, continental United States. Rough weather this morning, Tennessee and Kentucky, west into Arkansas and Oklahoma. A couple pockets of frequent lightning strikes at this hour from Nashville to Knoxville and from Little Rock to Fayetteville, Fort Smith. Couple thunder showers in the northeast at this time over upstate sections of New York near the Hudson River north of New York City and near the Finger Lakes region to the south of Rochester and Syracuse. Severe thunderstorm watch in effect. This is a relatively newly issued one within the last hour from the Storm Prediction Center. Parts of East Tennessee, western North and South Carolina, North Georgia, and Northeast Alabama. Severe thunderstorm watch remains in place here until early afternoon. So conditions are favorable for the severe storms in and near the watch region. At this hour, Coffee County in Tennessee, near Shelbyville, under a severe thunderstorm warning. And for Davison County, that is Metro Nashville, a flash flood warning remains in place as there's been some very heavy rain overnight, plus the fact that apparently at least one tornado touched down in the city during the nighttime hours. Out through northwest to Arkansas, heavy rain here on I-40 east of Fort Smith. Lighter showers in Oklahoma. The weather's calmed down for you overnight. In fact, overall, the showers and thunderstorms are on a weakening trend. However, as temperatures begin to warm, the frontal boundary slides south. A renewed outbreak of severe storms, a possibility today from the Carolinas west into Texas and Oklahoma. And not only is that severe weather threat with you, but heavy-duty, very torrential flooding rains of several inches, especially, again, from the western Carolinas and Tennessee into the lower Mississippi Valley. So on the surface map, cold front settling south, and it's clashing with warmth and moisture flowing north out of the Gulf of Mexico, the clash of air masses that we often talk about. So here in the northeast, showers for you. They're light by comparison to the mid-south, but we do have some wet weather nevertheless near Boston, near Providence and Hartford at this hour. A couple thunder showers again in the hills east of the Hudson River right here up in Dutchess County, northeast of Newburgh, and also in the southern tier of upstate New York near Ithaca, Elmira, and Cortland. Thunder showers. Syracuse got some rain at this time. Expected to continue at least for the first few hours of the morning. By contrast, let's go to the Great Lakes. Here, high pressure is moving in from the northwest, so expect an excellent day. Indianapolis, Detroit, Chicago, and also up towards Des Moines and Cedar Rapids. There's moisture in the place in the west. Look for showers and storms to be numerous across the plateau this afternoon. But drying out in New York City, Philadelphia, staying dry in New Orleans, but storms later, possibly in Atlanta, a good chance in Memphis, Chicago back to sunshine, Minneapolis and Madison too, and sunny today in LA after morning clouds, 72. Now here's your weekend, the big holiday weekend, Cheryl.
And this holiday weekend does promise to be a very warm one for the vast majority of the country. We're talking about 80s across the central plain states, the mid-Mississippi Valley, 80s and 90s blanketing most of the south, and then some extremely toasty temperatures throughout the southwest where the highs will easily eclipse the century mark. But if you're not too terribly fond of the hot weather, the place to go is across the north. As we draw closer towards the Canadian border, we'll see some 50s, 60s, and lower 70s. And unfortunately, much of the holiday weekend, too, could stay very wet and very stormy and unsettled throughout the east. Very intense thunderstorms could be bearing down on the Great Lakes and the Ohio Valley, at least for Saturday. And that will definitely put a major dent in some of those outdoor plans. Meanwhile, great weather for maybe some golf or tennis around Birmingham and Atlanta, Georgia. Nice weather, too, to head off to the beaches in Florida. But again, the east stays unsettled through Sunday, whereas the west is under that huge ridge of high pressure, and that keeps the weather fairly quiet and stable.
Well, we'll be dodging the showers in the east this weekend,
oh,
it looks like.
Sure.
Well, stay with us. More to come. Your local forecast is next. Stay with us.
First Outlook is sponsored by Kyocera Mita Digital Office Machines, where documents are going. Digital as documents get.
Your extended forecast.
Now in front of the hour, you're watching the Weather Channel. Bill Keneally here alongside Kelly Cass, and we continue to monitor the Southland today. Not much firing as of yet in Arkansas nor Oklahoma, and for that matter North Texas, but this area very vulnerable as the afternoon wears on. So traveling along I-40, say out of Amarillo into Fort Smith, Arkansas, be on your guard. Still watching North Carolina at this hour. Severe thunderstorm watch continues to the southeast of Raleigh, down around Kinston and Goldsboro, and all the way up in the south central areas of Virginia. That goes for another couple of hours. Check out the lightning tracker. You can see this core, the cluster of storms, has weakened some and also kind of narrowed in scope. That's good news here. Earlier about 10 o'clock in the morning, Greensboro, North Carolina at the airport, 81 mile per hour wind. Damages reportedly in the Kernersville area west of Greensboro. Also a plane crashed near the Chapel Hill Airport. There were some injuries with that, and it looks like weather was the cause of that accident. Checking out the radar at this hour, we continue to find rain kind of on the go there in the Chesapeake. Once you get north of D.C., though, very light, if any, rain. It's really in that rich, juicy air mass there in eastern North Carolina that we are watching very carefully. Here again, lingering rain in the Triad down towards Raleigh in the Beltline and southward down to about the Southern Pines, Pinehurst area. There's a big storm, though, coming in, so I'd watch this area right around Edenton, North Carolina. Could be some hail and high wind with that. And likewise on the Tidewater down to the beach, I think gusty winds and briefly very heavy rain likely on the Virginia Beach beachfront. And watch out Highway 12 anywhere from, say, Corolla, Duck, southward down to Nag's Head. Within the next hour, hour and a half, we're going to see some locally heavy rain. And well, for that matter, watching a lot of southeastern North Carolina, showers will likely fire in that warm and increasingly unstable air with the heating of the daytime. Plenty of rain going ahead of our frontal zone, kind of focused right here in a trough. We've had flooding along the middle fork, I believe, of the Kentucky River, flooding around Leslie in south central Kentucky, Leslie County, getting hit pretty hard at this hour. We continue to find the rain on the move today, coming north as a warm front starts arcing up in Oklahoma and Arkansas. The southern end of this could be active as well. We'll take that. The rainfall deficits are pretty awful, running at about a 9-inch deficit in Atlanta. And even without rain today, a 17-inch rainfall deficit for the year 2000 alone in New Orleans. This is on top of a dry latter 1999. And unfortunately, no rain in your forecast. Big area of high pressure camped out over the area. Same applies to Orlando. 95 in Orlando, the record's 98. We'll come close today. We had a record yesterday in central Florida. Here comes that rain lining up on I-40 in Texas and Oklahoma. We'll watch that area very carefully. And locally, again, another inch or a couple of inches of rain, a very good bet. You don't need any more after a 5-inch gully washer overnight in Nashville, Tennessee. Knoxville, you've been bombarded about 3 mornings in a row. And again, a very saturated soil here, so we'll have to monitor that situation very carefully. Watching the eastern Pacific Ocean as well, Hurricane Aletta packing top winds of 105 miles per hour, well west southwest of Acapulco, Mexico. Pressure very formidable, down to 970 millibars. The good news, though, outside of propagating big swells towards the coastal resort areas from Manzanillo to Acapulco, that will be about the worst of it. All the active weather stays offshore. The northeast, pretty active in its own right today. Concord, New Hampshire, hearing thunder right now. Low pressure is on the move, even had some storms in the metro Boston area. For now, though, it is up in northern regions of New England where the rain has been pretty heavy. We mentioned around Concord there in the Merrimack Valley. So watch out in the Granite State and in Maine, New York and Boston and Philly, brightening skies later on today.
Come back in like a half hour.
All right, Dad.
So what do you think about blue chip?
What's not to like?
Well, you're late.
Bobby, not today. It's not a day for big luck.
Come sit down. Can I get you some peach tea?
My husband's jealous of my portfolio.
Not a good day for Phil.
Phil, your hands are a mess.
My stockbroker just called me with news.
I'm sick about it. I mean, what do we tell my wife? She says to me, Phil, what's happening with our portfolio?
Phil's getting wacky out there.
Phil, have you heard of Ameritrade?
Oh, yeah.
Online trading.
$8 a trade, Phil.
One price, no gimmicks. So easy.
Ameritrade, huh?
Do it for yourself.
Girls, I got an email alert.
Oh, hey, what's going on?
Your extended forecast.
Welcome to Storm Watch, sponsored by True Value Hardware. I'm Nick Walker. Severe thunderstorms across portions of the southeast, including Georgia, South and North Carolina, and back toward the west, too, in Colorado. We've seen some moving through Wyoming into Nebraska. Let's take a look. It's a wide area where we could experience severe weather. One in the southeast, and that's where we have some severe thunderstorm watches. Georgia into North Carolina, South Carolina as well. And then the watches back here covering portions of New Mexico and Texas, Oklahoma, and on up into Colorado. Let's start with the southeast, and here around the Atlanta region, particularly to the north of you, you're seeing severe weather rumble through. Cherokee County, Southern Cherokee County, Northern Cobb County, and Northern Fulton County, you're all under severe thunderstorm warnings right now. You could see some gusty winds, of course torrential rain from this, and even some hail from some of these thunderstorms. You really want to take extra precautions here, as you may need to be patient waiting for some folks to get home from work here, as particularly if you're in the northern suburbs here around, say, Marietta, up toward Woodstock. And You may see some of these thunderstorms all the way back here along Interstate 22, Walker County in Alabama, under a severe thunderstorm warning. Some of these thunderstorms in South Carolina have had hail up to the size of 2 inches in diameter. There's still a problem here, and we have a warning for Harry County and Central Clarendon County in South Carolina. And in North Carolina, Columbus County and Bladen County in the northeastern portion of the state, you are still under warnings. Well, we still have a lot of moisture in the air here. The dew points well into the 60s, even some 70s. Moisture-laden air providing the fuel for some of these thunderstorms, and it is very humid and muggy. So we'll continue to see the severe weather, or the potential of it anyway, here in the areas in red, all the way back out here into portions of Texas, Oklahoma, New Mexico, and Colorado, as the front extends all the way back here. Warm, moist air overrunning this front, providing a few showers right now in Oklahoma. But we are seeing some severe weather here in New Mexico, particularly right along Interstate 40 here, Central Quay County. In the eastern portion of the state, you're under a warning.
Especially in parts of Texas and Oklahoma and Kansas. We will take a closer look at that in just a moment. But first, let's take a look at what's going on. Here's the overall picture. We have a front now extending from the mid-Atlantic region down through the southeast and right on back into the plains. A lot of the storms along the boundary in the southeast are beginning to quiet down or move out to sea. But farther westward, we have an upper level storm. Lots of dynamics here, a significant clash in terms of temperature and humidity, very warm and very humid air through much of Texas, drier and cooler air northward here, and this area is really going to keep going through much of the night tonight. It's going to be a rough night, so we really have to pay attention to this, and you do too if you live in these areas. Look at all the lightning here. Southwest Kansas, back through western Oklahoma, down through north and western parts of Texas. A few scattered strikes as we head back out into the west, and a big cluster here in South Carolina, but again, that's going to be moving out to sea. Very rough right along the coast right now, and we will take a closer look at that in just a moment. So here it is in Texas. We have a number of watches in effect here. Tornado watch in northwest Texas and a severe thunderstorm watch in western Oklahoma. These storms have been very, very nasty. A number of supercell storms here in and around the Amarillo area. They are pulling along towards the north here. More very big storms in western Oklahoma. Look at that one right there. Nasty looking cell here. There could be some wind and some large hail along with that. And then we're seeing more of the same into south and western parts of Kansas. Watch out in Wichita. Looks like some of that is beginning to move on in. We take you farther southward now. More storms north and east of Midland, north of I-20 here, and west of Wichita Falls. This area may continue to activate as we go through the night. And then farther northward, again, a lot of that beginning to spread into Kansas, and we do think that because the dynamics are fairly strong here, this area of storms may continue to go and not really quiet down as it moves right on up into Kansas. So you really do need to pay attention here, south and central parts of Kansas initially, and then through much of the state as we go through the night and into tomorrow morning. Farther north and westward, this is mostly moderate rain in Nebraska along the high plains here, and then scattered showers through Iowa, and that's going to be about it. It's pretty much rain and nothing else. Then in the southeast, we have scattered storms here in and around Alabama, and also this big cluster of storms here in South Carolina. This thing has been very, very nasty. Looks like a lot of the worst of it is right along the coast at this time, maybe just beginning to push off the coast. These storms have produced grapefruit size hail already tonight near Florence. The rain just beginning to end around Florence. Still a lot of very heavy rain farther northward towards Wilmington. Certainly some embedded thunder, and there could be some wind and some hail. So you do want to watch out for that. But again, this cluster is going to be moving offshore in about another hour or so. It should be clear up and down the coast here. And then finally, we take you into Alabama. We have a few storms west of Montgomery, just south of Meridian here in I-20. Slowly working along towards the south here, and there could be some fairly heavy rain here and some frequent lightning. Quick check on the northeast for you. Behind this boundary, we're seeing a few showers with a northwesterly flow. It's a bit cooler and showery parts of New York and Vermont. Not too many problems here. And in the west, we have had scattered showers through much of the west. A lot of this will quiet down without the benefit of daytime heating. You can see the scattered storms here. Notice how it's beginning to thin out, though, in the latter frames of the loop. Quick check on our tropical situation south of Mexico. This is the eastern Pacific, and we have Hurricane Aletta here. It is not very well formed at this point. There is still a fair amount of deep convection right around the center. It is being sheared, though. You can see the clouds kind of racing off towards the north and towards the east here. Here are the current stats. Winds 90 miles an hour, moving to the west at 1. As it moves a little farther westward, it will be moving into colder water. So we do expect it to diminish in intensity over the next couple of hours and next couple of days. So here's a look at your forecast. Scattered showers in the southeast once again tomorrow along this boundary. That's good news in terms of rainfall. You do need the rain here, but it could be active. This area right here could really, really be active tomorrow through Kansas and Missouri, and then farther north and eastward as that upper level system pulls on out. It could be a rough day in the Central Plains. So stay tuned to the Weather Channel for the very latest. And we'll have the very latest on your current situation coming up in just a few minutes.
Horsepower CL Type S.